Hello, I'm Josephine March. I'm
Josephine, Joe. This is Kitty and Minnie. And I see that you've already met our professor, and he's a very accomplished man.
Good afternoon, Miss March.
Oh, good afternoon.
You're on fire!
Thank you.
I have the same habit, you see.
Oh. Kitty and Minnie are waiting.
Oh, my students need me.
Always working.
Money is the end and aim of my mercenary existence.
No one gets ink stains like yours just out of a desire for money.
Well, my sister Amy's in Paris, and until she marries someone obscenely wealthy, it's up to me to keep the family afloat.
For the writer in the attic, because you enjoyed the play so much tonight, I wanted you to have this. It will help you study character and paint it with your pen. I would love to read what you're writing, if you'll trust me. I promise honesty and whatever intelligence I can muster.
Those are just stories, of course. But I'm working on a novel.
And your novel, it will be like this?
Yes.
With plots like this, jewels and killing?
It sells, so.
Why don't you sign your real name?
Oh, my mother wouldn't like it. It's too gory for her. And I want to help with the money I make and not worry her.
I think that they're not good. Honestly,
they're published in the papers, and people have always said that I'm talented.
Oh, I think you're talented, which is why I'm being so blunt.
I can't afford to starve on praise.
Are you upset?
Of course I'm upset. You just told me you didn't like my work.
I thought you wanted honesty.
Yes, I do.
Has no one ever talked to you like this before?
Yes, I've been rejected plenty of times.
Do you have anyone to take you seriously, Joe, to talk about your work?
And who made you high priest of what's good and what's bad, huh?
No one, and I'm not.
Well, then why are you acting like it?
Joe, your reaction indicates that
my
you must
reaction
think there is some truth.
Indicates that you are a pompous blowhard. Shakespeare wrote for the
Shakespeare
masses.
Shakespeare was the greatest poet who ever lived because he smuggled his poetry in popular works.
Oh, no Shakespeare.
Thank goodness we already have him.
If you know so much about it, then why don't you just do it yourself?
Because I'm not a writer? I don't have the gifts here.
No, you don't. And you will always be a critic and never an author, and the world will forget that you ever even lived.
Oh, I'm sure they will.
But I... No one will forget Joe March.
You can believe it.
Don't talk to me anymore. Thank you.
Oh, Josephine, this came for you.
Oh, thank you.
Gone? Why?
Where is Beth?
We all thought she was better, but the feeling weakened her heart.
Take this and find her the best doctor you can.
No, you need this money to live in New York.
No, I'm not going back.
But she didn't say if she was coming back.
Well, we didn't have a heart-to-heart, Professor.
I'm using the rest to take her to the sea and get her strong.
I love to listen to you read, Joe, but I just love it better when you read the stories you've written.
I don't have any new stories.
Why not?
I don't like them.
I don't think I can anymore.
He's fine.
You're much too lonely here, Joe. Wouldn't you like to go back to New York? What about your friend, Friedrich?
We are not friends. You are not my friend. And I don't want your opinion because I don't like you very much.
I ruined our friendship with my temper just as I ruined everything. I'm sure I'll never see him again.
I doubt that a sincere friend would be deterred.
What about the girls? She was the best teacher they ever had.
I know.
I wish that were true.
I'm starving.
Oh, Joe, you might want to wait.
I'm famished.
But, Joe, dear, you have a guest.
I don't know anyone.
I'm sorry to intrude, but...
It's you.
I was close by and I thought, like, I'd be good.
Please stay. We have more than enough room.
Someone told me he's rich.
I don't want to be a burden.
Oh, you're not a burden at all.
Yes, of course. Please.
I'm Lori. Who are you?
I'm Frederick Bell.
We were at the same boarding house together in New York.
Oh, Joe. He's very handsome.
Do you intend to stay in New York?
No, I've been offered a professorship in California. And as I have nothing keeping me here, I thought I might go west. It is new there, and they are less particular about immigrants. This is a beautiful instrument. Which one of you plays?
Oh, it was my sister Beth.
It is very hard to lose a sister.
Do you play?
Yes, I do.
That'll make us happy if you play now.
I don't wish to offend.
Not in the least.
If you ever come to California, I would love to see you.
I don't know that I will, but thank you.
Well, goodbye.
What? Why are you all looking at me like that?
Joe, you love him.
What? No, I don't.
Yes, you do. I've never seen you so happy. What else is love?
You need to go after him.
Lori, prepare the horses. We can catch him before he gets on the train.
I'm coming too.
Yes.
No, I'm not going.
Yes, you are. Amy is right.
Exactly.
Never thought I'd prepare a carriage to help Joe March chase a man, but I like
it. He's moving to California.
That was fiction. He was practically begging for a reason to stay.
But it's raining outside.
That doesn't matter. Can you come with me? I need to fix you.
I don't want you to leave. I want you to stay.
You do?
Yes.
But I would never leave if you wish me to stay.
No, I want you to stay.
I have nothing to give you, Joe.
It doesn't matter.
My hands are empty.
They're not empty.
Yours, Frederick.